Good morning, everyone. How are you feeling today? I'm sure everyone's feeling good.
Absolutely. Starting the day together always feel energizing.
As the world awakens to a new beginning, so do we. Welcome, dear ones, to a morning annual function where each one has a chance to shine and inspire.
So I, dear,
and I, Hasra,
welcome you all on the behalf of our class to the launch pad of our day.
You can go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending.
We live in a wonderful world that is full of beauty, charm and adventures. There is no end to the adventures that we can have only if we seek it with our open eyes.
The topic of our today's annual function is state government. A government is the institution in which a society makes and enforces its public policies.
The purpose of the government is not to rule, but to serve and uplift its citizens.
Before going to know more about the topic, let's start our day with the pledge.
So I would like to stand up and take your position. Put your right hand on your left shoulder and get ready for the pledge. O God,
O God,
I offer you
my studies,
thoughts,
words,
and actions of this day.
Enlighten my mind,
strengthen my memory,
and
guide me
to do
what's right. Amen.
Stop worrying about what could go wrong. Start focusing on what can go right. With this quotation, I would like to call Goima for thought of the day.
A strong government is where the will of the people matters, where the voice of the people is heard, and where the dreams of the people are fulfilled. I repeat my thought. A strong government is where the will of the people matters, where the voice of the people is heard, and where the dreams of the people are fulfilled. Thank you.
The success of a nation depends on the success of its state governments. A responsive and accountable state government is essential for building trust and confidence among the citizens. Now, to elaborate more about this topic, some students of our class are going to present the skit before you.
Dia and Goima are curious and trying to understand how the state government works. Hasrat, knowledgeable and explain things clearly. Scene 1, at the classroom during break time. Dia and Goima looking confused while reading a book about the government. Hasrat walks over.
Hey, you both look lost in thought. What's up?
Oh, hey, we have been reading about the government and we get to know what the central government does, but the state government is still a bit confusing.
Oh, I get it. The state government can be tricky to understand at first. Want me to help?
That would be great. So, where do we start?
Okay, let's start with what the state government does. You know how the central government handles big issues like foreign affairs, defences and national policies?
Yeah, like the Prime Minister and all those central ministers, right?
Exactly. Well, the state government handles everything closer to our home things like education, healthcare, roads and even policing in the state.
Oh, so the state government is in charge of schools and hospitals? That sounds pretty important.
It really is. They are the ones making sure our local services run smoothly. The central government can't handle everything across the whole country. So the states handle their own areas.
So, who's in charge of the state government?
The governor is the ceremonial head. They are like the president for the country. But the real power lies with the chief minister. They are like the prime minister for the state.
How is the governor chosen? Do the people vote for them?
No, the governor is chosen by the President of India. The central government decides who the governor will be and they serve a term for 5 years.
Oh, so the chief minister makes decisions for the state? Just like the prime minister does for the whole country.
Exactly. Chief minister and council of ministers make decisions for the state, like how to run things in the state, like roads, buildings, improved schools and handling state level issues.
So, does the chief minister pass laws too?
Well, the state legislature passes laws. Some states have 2 houses, legislative assembly and legislative council, and some just have 1 house. These lawmakers debate and pass laws specific to the state.
I get how laws are passed. But where does the state government get the money to run schools and hospitals?
Good question. The state government can collect its own taxes like vehicle tax, property tax and sales tax. They use this money to fund all the services that benefit us.
So, when we pay tax,
taxes that help us to run the local things like the roads we use and the schools we go to.
Exactly. Plus, the central government gives some funds to the states to support bigger projects. But a lot of money comes from the taxes collected within the states.
Wow, I didn't realize that. The state government has so much power.
They are really responsible for a lot of things that affect our daily life.
Yeah, that's why understanding the state government is so important. They make sure our local needs are met, while central government focuses on bigger picture.
It's like the central government is the big boss of the country, but the state government is the manager for the specific region.
That's the great way to think about it. Both the level of the government are different and important. Both have different responsibilities. Thanks for the lesson. I think I get it now.
The state governments make a big difference in our everyday life.
Glad I could help. Now let's get to the class before the teacher starts adding punctuality to the lesson plan.
Remember, each of us has a role to play in shaping the future of our state. Knowing about your state government is the first step to being an engaged citizen. Let's all remember that an informed citizen is an empowered one. Ultimately, effective state governments are essential for a thriving democracy and the well-being of society as a whole.
Thank you. A state government is essentially the government that controls a subdivision of country. It's like a smaller version of national government with its own powers and responsibilities. State governments have their own executive, legislative and judicial branches. So here are some key aspects of state government.
Power. State government have power to make laws on subjects such as education, healthcare, agriculture, and infrastructure development.
Structure. State government are headed by a chief minister and have a council of ministers similar to the central government.
The governor is the head of the state. The constitution provides executive powers of the state to the governor. He appoints the chief minister and the ministers on the advice of the chief minister.
The governor of a state is appointed by the president for a term of 5 years and holds office during his pleasure.
State governments in India are the governments ruling over 28 states and 8 union territories of India. Power is divided between the union government and the state government.
Legislature. State governments have a legislative assembly, Vidhan Sabha or legislative council Vidhan Parishad that make laws for the state.
The Vidhan Sabha is the lower house and corresponds to the Lok Sabha, while the Vidhan Parishad is the upper house and corresponds to the Rajya Sabha of the Parliament of India.
Executive. The Chief Minister and the Council of Ministers are responsible for implementing laws and policies. Executive functions are policy implementation, budget management, public safety and appointment. Each state has its own constitution, so the structure and responsibilities of the executive branch can vary significantly.
Judiciary. State governments have their own judiciary with the High Court as the highest court.
Responsibilities. State governments are responsible for providing public services such as healthcare, water supply, sanitation, and education.
Finances. State governments have their own budget and revenue sources such as taxes and grants from the central government.
Autonomy. State government have a degree of autonomy in decision making but are also subject to oversight and guidance from the central government.
Some examples of state government initiative includes healthcare program like the Tamil Nadu government's Kalainakamiduditam. Several Indian state government have launched healthcare program aimed at providing affordable and accessible healthcare to residents.
Education initiatives like the Kerala government's Vidyashree programs. Its objective to provide financial assistance for the higher education of economically backward students, particularly those belonging to a marginalized community.
Infrastructure development projects like the Maharashtra government's Mumbai Metro. Many state governments in India are implementing large-scale infrastructure projects similar to Maharashtra's Mumbai Metro aim to improving urban connectivity, transportation and overall infrastructure.
Social welfare scheme like Andhra Pradesh government's Ammavati program. Ammavati scheme aim to improve school attendance and reduce dropout rates by providing financial assistance to families. This program promotes literacy, sport, low income families and addresses educational inequality by reducing the economic burden of schooling.
The four characteristics of a state in the United States are territory, population, government, and sovereign.
State government should focus on creating employment opportunities and boosting the local economy. Entrepreneurship support to reduce unemployment and boost growth.
The state government in India is responsible for governing all matters that fall under the state subject as per the Indian Constitution. This includes areas like law and order, health, education, transportation, agriculture, and more. Thank you.
So, now I would like to call Harshit Agarwal on the stage for an instrumental performance. शिक्षा स्वास्थ्य विकास का ध्येय हर गांव शहर में लाए नव में सड़कों पुलों बिजली की बात राज्य सरकार करती है साकार।
जन जन की सुनती करती बात न्याय सुरक्षा देती सौगात प्रगति का पथ विकास की राह राज्य सरकार बनाए सजीव सपन।
करती है सेवा बिन भेदभाव हर वर्ण का देती है सम्मानित भाव हम सबके हित में है एक ही नारा
राज्य सरकार सबका सार राज्य सरकार सबका सार धन्यवाद।
The world is full of poetry. The air is linked with its spirit and the waves dance to the melodies and sparkle in its brightness. So here, the Pesh and Hasandeep are going to present an English poem.
In states, leaders meet to discuss and decide, making sure everyone's needs are supplied.
They talk about laws and plans to make things right, working hard from morning until night.
They listen to people and what they need to make sure everyone can succeed.
Their job is to help and to guide in every town far and wide.
Through trials and
campus, they persevere, state government's mission crystals clear. To build a future that's strong and bright, guided by principles shining with light. To build a future that's strong and bright, guided by principles shining with light.
Thank you.
We dance for laughter, we dance for tears. We dance for madness, we dance for fears. We dance for hopes, we dance for screams. We all are dancers, we create the dreams. Now, it's time for a beautiful classical dance performance by some girls of our class.
Thank you.
Hold her beat for a singing performance. Yes, Hasrat is going to draw the strings of her heart and add the soothing voice to cherish her souls by chanting a beautiful English song.
अभी तो जंग है जारी। अभी हारा नहीं है तू, अभी हारा नहीं है तू, जो जहर कंच सारे ऐसा बेचारा नहीं है
तू। अभी तो जंग है जारी, अभी हारा नहीं तू, जो जहर कंच सारे